All the windows fastened down. I spent the night in sleeplessness, rose at every sound. Half in hopeless sorrow and half in fear the day would find the soldiers breaking through to drag us all away. Just before the sunrise, I heard something at the wall. The gate began to rattle, a voice began to call. I hurried to the window, looked down into the street, expecting swords and torches and the sound of soldiers' feet. There was no one there but Mary, so I went down to let her in. John stood there beside me as she told us where she'd been. She said they'd moved him in the night, and none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away, and now his body isn't there. We both ran toward the garden, and John ran on ahead. We found the stone in the empty tomb, just the way that Mary said. With the winding sheet they'd wrapped him in, just an empty shell. How and where they'd taken him was more than I could tell. Something strange had happened there, just what I did not know. John believed a miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstance and speculation couldn't lift me very high. See him crucified, and I saw him die. Back inside the house again, the building was kings. Everything I'd promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. Even if strange and sweet perfume, a light that came from everywhere drove shadows from the room. Jesus stood before me with his arms held open wide. I fell down on my knees and I clung to him.
Thank you.
We